most of the my classmates from high school that we graduated with from high school were done with school way before when I by the time I was graduating. Mm-hmm. So time is very very important. So yes. that time I think that was the challenge. Mm-hmm. Then also trying to balance because it's really active in campus. Mm-hmm. In campus you did a lot of stuff. So you mm-hmm. can Google my name. I was in the top 100 students some years back. Wow. I was number 35. There was the Ultimate University Awards. I was managing a friend of mine, Billy Weber, a great artist. He's doing okay. So I was doing all these things. I was also managing BD Hulu. So there's all these things and trying to coordinate all these things. So trying to balance them with school and trying to deal with administration. So it really helped me to know how to work around teams, try to work with the people, different kinds of people, how to ask from people favors, how to execute ideas and all that. So there were challenges, but I used them to define who I am, to define a personality. So it has really helped me to transition into the work life, because work is not as glamorous or as pretty as people think. Mm-hmm. Work, there's so many challenges, office politics and all that and all that. So if you're already dealing with people, you already know what happens. It's easier for you to deal with people like this. Yeah, so yeah, people are a great resource.
So was there any point that you reached and you say, now I wish I knew, I could not even come to campus? A point that you were to go giving up?
I think the best thing you can ever do is to go to campus, because it gives you access. It gives you access to a whole lot of people. You meet so many kind of different people. Guys from Alliance, guys from some other place, guys from rich families, guys from, you know, you meet so many people, you interact with so many people, you get to know a lot of people, you get to grow your network effortlessly. Growing your network after school is very hard, but school you have access to people. So people, the next business people, the next politicians are your immediate friends. They're not, people don't come from us to take these positions that are being held by probably some other people, CEOs, corporate owners, leaders and all that. So these are people who are sitting in your class right now. Mm-hmm. So you should have their numbers already before they become who they will be or what destiny defines them. So take those numbers, be their friends. You don't know who, just bank on your friends and have as many friends as possible. Avoid blocking people, try working out something. Despite the disappointment, don't block your ex. Yeah, keep her, keep him. Yeah, you can work together as a project. Yeah, so to answer your question, yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, when I was saying that towards the end of your undergraduate studies, we always have some fears, like there is just something that you fear. Did you, in any chance, happen to be in such a situation that you fear going out?
Yeah, of course. The I think the biggest fear of an undergraduate when you're graduating is, will I get a job? Because you're done with school. So we are used to a system after primary, you're going to high school. After high school, you're going to a tertiary institution. So what happens after this? So I think that's normally the scare. And also the change of, I think this comes a bit later, the transition from school now to life.
To life, yes.
Yeah, so I think that's also a scare, and it drives a lot of people into depression, because how do you balance, especially if you have the perception of everybody is doing fine, everybody is working somewhere, everybody is doing something. So I think that's the scare, I think, that many people. And for some universities is will I appear on the graduation list?
Oh, like Moi specifically?
Yeah, uh-huh. Specifically Moi. I really love Moi, but that's the mere. Yeah, but yeah.
So, things like open music, it affected you?
Yeah, but I was a good student. I attended all my classes. I really tried to,
Okay, thank you so much. So you are outside there, you're doing very great work. So there is also the reason of looking for attachment. How did you manage to get attachment?
Again, networks. So you really have to grow, build a relationship with your lecturers, in your relationship with the friends. So businesses and also people, they thrive with the referrals.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, if you're doing what you're doing, they know you do what you're doing.
Yeah.
So if someone is looking for someone who does, I'd recommend you. So most organizations, probably 2/3 of organizations that hire, they don't post their jobs, they advertise internally. Because it's very expensive to advertise for jobs.
Yeah.
So if you know someone who knows someone, it's easier to get that job. So yeah. So organizations just and also I'd encourage you to just send great good CVs and cover letters everywhere. So you won't be called for the interview per se, but they normally keep your CV.
Yeah.
So if this guy leaves, you'll be the first person to be considered.
Okay.
So they'll call you for an interview, regardless. So after some, it might be 2 years, it might be a year, it might be three, but they'll call you at a point, as long as you are in their contact list or something. So, yeah. So, networks.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So that's how you actually go to touch with places and possibly the work you are doing right now.
Absolutely.
Because of the friends you have, so you share the idea.
And my relationships. Mm-hmm. Different people, lecturers and all that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much, Bwana Ferdinand. I think we are very glad to have you right now here. I know you are busy, there is something you are doing right now. Maybe if you can tell us about the meeting going on.
Just an
overview of it.
Okay, so basically it's a campaign.
Mm-hmm.
It's a campaign, as I mentioned, and and also into digital marketing and all that. So we are running a campaign to tailor businesses, to help businesses and university students who are getting into institutions, to tailor, to be crusaders on climate change and whatever organizations that are going to change. Because whether we give climate change attention or not, it's happening. And in our own small way, we can start putting in initiatives that can really shape our destinies or our futures. So our future really depends on what the human activity that happens right now. So we decided to, rather than starting in having the first event in Nairobi, we decided to have the event first in Georgia. And so that's the conference that's going on right now, trying to discuss these issues, trying to basically ignite the spark on students' minds that climate change is a factor that they should consider in the businesses that they're starting, and also organizations or businesses that they're joining, and also just basically encouraging everyone that everyone to champion for that. Yeah.
So your business is based in Nairobi?
Do
you offer delivery?
Yeah, we do worldwide actually delivery. So we ship products. We shipped a couple to Europe, and we also sell locally. So we do deliveries from Nairobi to all towns in Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So like, how much is the t-shirt?
So
for example, the
t-shirt
you're putting on,
this is 1,000. Okay, so 999. Yeah, 1,000.
Mm-hmm.
We have polos that go for 1,200. We have playing cards that go for 500. We're working on, at some point, getting into cigars, getting into whiskey, getting into all this kind of stuff. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It will be interesting. So I'd really ask people to follow our page. Actually, it's Tajiri. I think you'll run it below the your screen.
Yes,
so it's
yeah.
Tajiri
mm-hmm.
_EST.1337.
So that is where anybody who wants to make their product
region. Yeah,
so
true.
If I'm in Nairobi right now and I want to order now, how much are the costs now?
We have a standard courier fee
mm-hmm.
of 200.
Okay.
So regardless of where you are, Mombasa, Kisumu, Nakuru, it's 200, so it's 1,000 more plus 200, that's 1,200. Yeah.
Okay.
So,
are there
we do free deliveries in Nairobi.
Are there any challenges that you encountered in between the delivery, apart from where you deliver product and there's a person trying to pay?
So, before we do a delivery, you have to pay first. Upfront, yeah. But so far, we haven't lost any products in our deliveries, so the deliveries have been really efficient. So, we sent pictures before dispatching the product, the systems have been efficient. Yeah.
Okay, so maybe one more thing, what advice can you give to the continuing students who are still in campus right now?
Keep networking. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Be friends with everyone. Work with everyone. Do something. Do something. Join politics. Start a business. Vie for anything. Basically, be out there. Show up. For the events that are happening, try and attend them. Just network. Talk to everyone. Try and beat your insecurities. So don't watch as many movies. So yeah, try doing what you guys are doing. Try shooting something. That's what I'd advise.
Okay, thank you so much, Peter and Uganda, for joining us today in our interview. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We appreciate your time, and of course, we wish you all the best as you'll be traveling. Also, we wish you a very safe journey.
Thank you.
Of course, and then you may stay safe for us because we still need these products.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best.
I'll be waiting for your orders.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.